Are there any questions to what we just talked about? Okay, I'm just gonna make an imaginary fire mission for you. We're gonna hit the town of we're gonna hit the town of Polina. Polina is at grid 106180.
Can you repeat the grid?
106180 or 080, correct, sorry. And the town's elevation is approximately 211, 211. And you might want to always write these things down with pen and paper, just because if for some reason you lose the data or you have to repeat the fire mission, then you have it written down already. Because for strange and inexplicable reasons, this computer doesn't always save stuff. Polana. Target description, that would just be build a barrier. It's a width of 200 meters. If you only put in the width, then the computer is gonna assume you're talking about a circle. If you put in length, it's gonna assume it's a rectangular mission and it wants an attitude. So we're just gonna put in radius 200 meters. Then you close no. It's just gonna be HE delay. 5 rounds. One round adjust count, one piece adjust. Fire at my command. And then once you put in all that information, you press the gray button that says FFE slash adjust. FFE stands for fire for effect, or adjust, of course. Once you click that, it will start making what's called fire solutions. Then you get two solutions. You get what's called a low solution, and that's the lowest possible arc of fire to hit the target. That means you get a fast time of flight. In this case, you only have to the rocket will only have to fly for 16.4 seconds, and then it will impact. The problem with that is if there are hills or mountains between us and the target area, you would just hit those instead. You will also get a high solution, which is the highest possible arc of fire, which is good if there's a mountain or hill in the way, but it gives a much longer mission. Yeah, that's a JTAC's job. What was I? Yes. So the high solution in this case would be give us a time of flight of 27.7 seconds. That's worth taking into account, depending on the situation in the AO. If it's a friendly unit that desperately needs fire support ASAP, you might have to use a low-angle fire mission. But if you have a lot of airborne assets in the area, then you might want to do a high angle just in order to allow them to stay on gr at ground level without getting hit. Then you get get a bunch of information in connection to that solution. We're going to talk about the high solution because it's most commonly used. You actually get all the information you need to tell your battery when they fire. You need to tell them fire mission. That's the first thing they need to know. They need to know there is a fire mission. Then you tell them platoon adjust, which means it's this is for the this platoon, for instance. Imagine you have three platoons. You say first platoon adjust, then the first platoon knows it's their mission and they have to do an adjust mission. Number one, the first mission is 1 round, and then and you say special instructions at my command. That means it's only at the FO's command. We're not gonna shoot before he asks us to. Then you give an azimuth. That's not relevant to in this game. Then you give a charge for the round. give the deflection of the gun and the quadrant. Quadrant is for some reason they say quadrant here when they mean elevation on the gun. That is the elevation. Then you tell them 5 rounds, fuse delay in effect. Once you've told your battery that, and then you need to inform the FO what you have decided to do about his call for fire. And then you'd call up the observer and say, this is guard hand, HE in effect, 1 round TRP 0001, cover flight 47.7 seconds. So he knows that there's 1 round of HE coming in 47 seconds after we say shot. Are there any questions on this? Oh. You must always remember to give the message to observer. Because if you don't give that, then the observer is just like, is this fire mission coming? Did they even hear me? He gets all kinds of weird stuff going on, and what might happen is that he calls you again, and that's just annoying, basically. So just as soon as you have calculated a mission, you just give a fire mission, HE in effect, 1 round, TRP-1, time flight 47 seconds. That's also where he hears if you have decided something else. For instance, he asked for DPICM, and you decide, I'm running low on DPICM, and HE can do the same, can have the same effect. So I decided on using HE. Okay. Let me just look over my notes quick. Nope. Okay, that's pretty much a grid mission right there. That's what you need to do as an FDC when doing grid missions. Those are fairly simple missions. We're going to talk about it just later on. So, for now, just go ahead and go click the back button a couple of times until we get back into the main menu. The next thing we have is what's called a polar fire mission. Polar fire missions are when the FO knows where his own grid is, but he's not sure what grid he's looking at. For instance, he needs to hit a certain house in town, or he needs to hit something in the open field, and he can't really figure out the exact grid of that point. But he knows the distance to it, and he knows the compass direction to it. And then we can use our computer and our clever brains to figure out what grid we need to hit. So go ahead and click polar. Now all of you should see a completely new menu. And this is where knowing your observers beforehand is a pretty good idea, because then you can just click this drop down list and so say, oh, observer dropkick, yeah, there it is. If you don't know the observer beforehand, then you can just start writing him in. So dropkick. I'm just going to make up a grid for dropkick real quick. Dropkick is at grid 0909 085. He has his altitude is 291. And then he will give you what's called an OT direction. OT stands for observer to target. So that's from him to the target. He gives you a direction in mils. He could say OT 2400. Then he knows pretty much the range. It could be that he has a vector and he can pretty accurately say there is 700 meters out there. But it could also be that he's just looking at open field. He doesn't have the tools for figuring out where exactly he needs to hit. So he can just say 500 meters. And then that's his estimate. And the idea is here that we need to adjust fire based on his estimate, because he's not sure what enemy is. And then we need to add in if there is a difference in the altitude. For instance, he's sitting on a hilltop, in this case. So there would be an altitude difference from what he's trying to hit. For instance, if he's trying to hit the T-intersection to his north, then we would be at an altitude that's 284. That gives us a difference of roughly 6 meters. Then we need to put that in as well. Then we do the target description just as we did before. And with minus 6. Good question, General. It's a good question. And then, of course, we go in onto the method of engagement. That looks pretty much the same as before. And the method of control also works in the same way. Once we've decided on what we're going to do about the mission, for instance, he asked for HE delay, we decide to use the pick'em, so we decide to do something else, then we've decided now. Put in that information, and then click Firefox effect /adjust. Just put in some random info, it's not important really. Then again we get the fire solution. Now we get less information, mostly because I put out and took away some special instructions. Then as soon as we get this solution, we tell our battery, fire mission, platoon, 3 rounds, HE, charge 5, use quick, deflection, 5164, quadrant 1048. Message to observer, dropkick, discard hand, effect, quick in effect, 3 rounds, TRP 1, time flight, 49.1 seconds. That's pretty much what you need to do as an FTC. And the quicker you can do this, the more effective you can work. Then once the guns start firing, you'll give the FTC and the FO some more information we'll go over later. Are there any questions on Polar fire missions? Okay. So, close mission. Last thing is shift. It's pretty obvious. Anyone tell me what shift is? No one?
If you have
a pre-designated target and you kind of shift your direction of fire from that point.
Exactly. So we know, for instance, we know exactly the grid of a church in a town. We have that church 8-figure grid. So what we're gonna do is the forward observer. He doesn't know his own grid. He doesn't know the target grid, but he know but he knows that church is a known point to us. We know exactly where that church is, so he can say Polona, a church in Polona. Okay, we're just gonna look that up on our list. Oh yeah, we called that TRP-7. Then he's gonna give us an OD direction, which is again his compass direction in mils. That could be 4200. And then what he's gonna give us is telling us from where he sees it, how much to the left or how much to the right of the target is, how much close or farther away it is, and how much higher or lower in the terrain it is. This might not make sense immediately. So I'm gonna put up something on the map to show you.
I have one question on hand.
Yeah.
Is left a negative number, or is that right? And it also kind of goes, what's a negative number? Well, oh, no, never mind. I know what add drop is.
Yeah. Okay. So I'm just finding something to make this example really obvious. Yeah, let's use Gorka. all of you can find the town of Gorka, right? Does anyone not see Gorka and TRP 107? Okay. So in this imaginary case, we have enemy OP here at grid 0904, 0910, and we have our friendly observer here. So he knows. Oh, that's why. Yeah, sorry. I was in group chat with the other guys. One second. Does anyone not see those now around Gorka? Okay, so in this imaginary example, the FO can see the church, and he can see the enemy OP. He couldn't in real life because of the building, whatever. So he knows, he estimates that there's 200 meters, 250 meters up to the enemy OP from the PO zone. This is a crappy example, actually. I'm changing something, one second. Gonna move him over here so it makes more sense. Okay. So he's looking at the TRP-7. And he gets his OC direction from there. Gonna make sure what it is. Ah, damn your instructor slot. Okay. Yeah. He has his OC direction. And then he knows that the enemy is going so far to the left of the objective compared to him, and so much closer. So he would say right, 250 meters, drop 50 meters, and change in elevation. That. And up. Let's say up 10. Is this making sense what I'm saying now? Now you need to speak up because we're gonna do this later, and if you don't understand then you're gonna miss a lot.
Are these numbers from the TRP or from you?
Good question. Yeah, those are when you look at the TRP, he has his observer to target direction. Then, from the TRP to the target, there is 200 meters to the right, for instance. And it might be 100 meters closer, then drop 100. It might be 20 meters lower in the terrain, then down 20.
From the TRP 107.
Yeah, from TRP. So he knows where. So polar mission, that's from the FO's position, and the shift mission is from the TRP because he doesn't necessarily know exactly where he himself is.
And then I say drop from the position where I see the enemy to the TRP.
I almost feel like we have gotten the terrain to show this. I'm just thinking.
What you're trying to say is, imagine you're standing at the FO position, looking down at TRP. So basically, you'll be adjusting fire. You can see your the enemy target is basically to the right when you're looking at the church, and then etc. etc.
Yeah, exactly what Killing is saying. That from where you're seeing church, then to the right of the church, for instance, that amount of meters to the right of that church from where you're seeing it. That's where, and that's why, that's where you, that's where you get it. Yeah, that could be right 50, for instance. Then if the enemy is between you and the church, it could be drop 50 or drop 100, depending on how close they are to you, depending on from or how far away they are from the church. If the church is between you and them, then it would be add something. And if the enemy is lower or higher in the terrain, it would be up something or down something. I really, otherwise, don't worry too much about this, because this is the FO's job to figure out for you. He needs to tell you what you need to put in there. I'm just, this is just to orient you guys about what he's trying to tell you. But it's the FO's job to say, write 100, add 200. That's his job. You pretty much just do what he says, because you can't see what's going on out there.
I think I have to see it outside in the FO's course. Then
it's yeah. It will make more sense. Also, when you get this link, there are some pretty pictures that shows you exactly what I'm trying to explain. Yes, OC direction is the direction from the observer to the target. Yes. In a shift mission, the target will be the target reference point or the known point, whereas in a polar mission, the target will be the target. Okay. Next thing we're going to go over is communicating between FO and FDC, so go ahead and get out of your vehicles and we'll form a little school circle. Just rally up in front of the vehicles. Okay, I realize this might have been like a bit confusing. I hope it wasn't too bad. Necessary, we'll have to re-explain this some more on Thursday. But I think most of